Shut up and sit down.
Letter from a newspaper correspondent of a national daily to the editor on the destruction caused by flood and the relief measures are taken by the administration. Dated 17 June 2021. To the editor, Indian Express, Bahadur Shah Zafar Mark, New Delhi, 110002. Subject: Destruction by Flood and Relief Measures. Respected Sir or Madam, I hereby submit to you a report on the flood situation in the Roper district of Haryana. Floods have become a common feature in our country during the rainy season. This time, it has affected many areas of Haryana, but the situation in Roper is the worst. Thousands of people have been rendered homeless. At least 22 persons are reported to have been drowned. Thousands of people have been marooned owing to heavy rainfall. Two railway tracks have been badly damaged and many roads are under knee-deep water. Property worth crores of rupees has been destroyed. The people of the area are facing the calamity bravely. The Haryana government is handling the situation on a war footing. The rescue and relief operations are going on in full swing. The medicine, clothes, and other necessary articles are being supplied to the flood-stricken people by the government and voluntary organizations. Many boats have been pressed into service to rescue the marooned people. The Chief Minister of Haryana is personally supervising the relief operation and has announced an outlay of Rs. 50 crores to resettle the affected people. Many voluntary organizations from neighboring Punjab and Delhi have sent relief material to the affected people. The government has exempted the farmers from payment of land revenue and postponed repayment of loans. The situation now appears to be quite under control, though most of the areas in the state are still submerged in water. Several police and military teams have been maintaining round-the-clock vigil and strategic points. It is hoped that in a week or so, there will be a marked improvement in the situation. Thanking you, yours faithfully, Raghunath Jaiswal, correspondent.